Snaps, this is Jordan with the Gray. Welcome back to another exciting episode of Minecraft Jurassic World Edition. Sorry for the... Well, I'm not real sorry. I mean, there's been a bit of a delay based on my previous uploading schedule. I've got a bed in here now since I don't have one at the RV. I just finished sleeping off the night. But I've been putting out more frequently, and then I took a little bit of break. The episodes this week have been slightly less frequent because I've been working on some other projects and things like that. Morning, Casper! So last episode, what were we doing? Last episode, we had a hatching extravaganza, that's right. Which means today we have a naming extravaganza planned. We're also going to do a little bit of work on a couple of other things. Actually, naming extravaganza is apt because I've actually come up with some names for a couple of other things as well. But let's start off today. Let's go ahead and name tags. Let's see. How many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 licks to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop. Alrighty, so you guys were amazing. I got more name suggestions on last episode than I've gotten in ages for one of these things. So thank you guys so much for all of that. Now, today we've got 4 name suggestions, and I want to stress, don't feel bad if your name didn't get picked. Like I said, there was a large number of name suggestions given. So honestly, I had to pick and choose, and I tried to pick ones that really stood out to me. Oh, I'm not used to hearing the parasaurs out here at the dig site. But yeah, so we've got 4 name suggestions. We're gonna start off from the top here. And we have Diego, which was suggested to us by Jackson Brown, and that is gonna be the name of our new Smilodon. Thank you so much, Jackson, for that name suggestion. I think that was the only one. I think that might have been the only suggestion we potentially got for the Smilodon, but it was a good one. I think that's the guy from Ice Age or whatever, which, hey, more power to you. I think our Fossils and Archaeology Mammoth is also named after one of the guys from Ice Age, so hey, I'll take it. Alrighty, so thank you so much for the suggestion, Jackson. Now, actually, I'm going to save this one for last. Let's go to the next one then. So for our male parasaur, our new Fossils and Archaeology male parasaur, this one is going to be called Robespierre, which I don't know if I'm saying that right. It's French. And I'm spelling it wrong. I'm supposed to be... There we go. Supposed to be an S there. Okay, so that is the name, and it was... That specific name was suggested by Norm Minlin. But I'm also subsequently crediting Avalardo Orzeco, Orozco. I'm sorry, I'm not the best with names. Avalardo Orozco. He suggested that we name, Avalardo suggested that we name the parasaur Bonjour, something French, because Paris, now technically it's pronounced parasaur. So, parasaur, not paras, not Paris, like the Pokemon, even though it's kind of spelled similarly. So, the French connection isn't necessarily technically correct, but he suggested we name it something, but bonjour isn't a noun or a name of any sort, so, but I used his suggestion that we name it something French-related to push over the edge Norm Minlin's suggestions of naming it something French-related. So that's what we went with. So thank you both, Norm Minlin and Avalardo. I'm crediting you both with Robespierre there. Okay, so the last two we've got here, let's see, we're saving the last one. So Aiden Slayer suggested we nickname, or not nickname, but name our, I'm not even typing. Here we go. That we name, not Anzu, Abs, that we name our new plesiosaur Abzu, which is, it's some underwater exploration game that I know Mara's been playing. I haven't really seen it pop. I think maybe Sari's playing it now too, potentially, but I saw Mara play it a little bit, and he says that there's a plesiosaur that shows up in that game, which is, that's pretty cool. So, and that was a good name. Why not? Let's go for it. So, Abzu, Aiden Slayer, thank you so much for the name suggestion. All right, final one, and I do this begrudgingly, but I did have multiple people suggest it for this specific dinosaur even, so our new female Gallimimus is going to be nicknamed Standy, which if you guys have not been watching my streams and or my stream highlight or archives that I've been uploading, it was found out last week that on my BRB screen it said, be right back, please stand by, is what it was supposed to say. Please stand by. And I made these BRB screens back in March, and I don't stream a lot, so they haven't seen a ton of use, but I've used them on and off since March, and last week somebody noticed, hey, it doesn't say stand by, that just says standy. It was a typo, and it's been there forever, and so everybody tagged onto it, and it's been this whole thing, and everybody's been bringing it up for like a week, and that was specifically suggested in the comments by the White Selkie and Gustavo Franco. So, since they both suggested that for the Gallimimus specifically, I figured I had to oblige. But yeah, so there we go. That's why we're naming the Gallimimus Standy. Let's pop in here and let's get Robespierre. And we will name, there we go. So there we go. Our little parasaur is now nicknamed Robespierre. So that works out pretty nicely. So there we go. And with Fluffy there, so these guys are all named, I believe. So we've got Pippin over there. Diego is over here. So let's go ahead and get his name suggestion. But thank you to everybody who submitted a name suggestion. I really do appreciate it. I love getting the subscriber feedback from you guys. On all of that to make it just makes the park that much more fun knowing that you guys are the ones who named the dinosaur. So there we go. Diego doesn't appear to be hungry. Does look like he's growing a bit though, so that works out pretty nicely. You stay right in there, you little cat. Okay, who do we got left? Standy and Abzu. Okay, Abzu is gonna take us to the front of the park, so let's do that one first. Yeah, because we're gonna be going to the back of the park here anyway. We've got a little bit of stuff to do in the back of the park. I did finally get a new Gallimimus egg cultivated, so we're probably going to try and hatch that in the back. And then I did also finish off the Arseniotherium, replacing all of the water in that enclosure with blue glass, made a little bit more of that up, and was able to finish off that enclosure. So we should be able to reinstall our Arseniotheriums today, which will be exciting. Be exciting. Hopefully they'll be able to grow up happy and healthy. I should have thought about that before just a second, but we probably should at some point reinstall and get another Arseniotherium in there. But for now, I kind of want to let these two grow up happy and healthy, and then I will decide on, you know, potentially adding another one once I determine that the enclosure is completely safe. All right, so we're looking for little Abzu. And she is rather little, so we've got to keep an eye out for her. Nobody else is hanging out over here. I wonder if she's made her way over to this group. We kind of hatched her over there. Figured she'd probably stay over there, but nope. It looks like she's definitely been attracted over to the rest of the pond, which works out. That's fine. I think she's the little one in the back there. Makes sense that she'd want to be with her kind, and they're all enjoying this specific, Alright. Okay, little one, I don't want to rename somebody else, so you've got to work with me here. Okay. Come on. Oh, I thought I had her there for a second. Uh-oh, I'm seeing hearts. Okay, she's this little one here. Here, wait. I don't have a conch shell on me though, do I? Let's look in our tool pack really quick. I was gonna say, it might be easier if we get her to sit or something. No, I've got all my other order ones besides the empty shell or whatever. Darn it. Did I just throw one of my packs on the ground? What? Tools pack? Creatures pack? Where's my materials pack? Where's my materials pack? I need that today, actually. Did I just drop it? Oh no, if I've accidentally tossed out my materials pack at some point, that's gonna be bad. There was a lot of stuff in there. Okay. Alright, hold on. Abzu. Abzu. Where is she? There she is. And, oh, moved around again. Now when I'm close to him, I can't tell which one she is. Oh no. This is her. They look the same. Okay, you know what? Oh, I think we got her. I think we got her. Okay, so hold on. We got monster. We've got Locke. We've got Nessie. Okay, and so that means that Abzu, yes, we got her. Woo! I was worried I was gonna have to like cut and do that. Okay, but no. She got offered. Okay, did I? Crap, what happened to my materials pack? Crap. Darn it, I really hope I didn't just like throw that on the ground. That had a lot of stuff in it. Nothing that can't be replaced, obviously, but I'd kind of put stuff we needed for today in there. I made a bunch of collapsible. We were gonna do some work on the bomber and grill, and I put some stuff in there for the purposes of doing that. Hold on. We do need to quickly run back. I can't remember if it was there when we started the episode or not. Now, I remember getting my inventory all organized before the start of the episode, and it was there. For sure there, because I put stuff in it while I was prepping for the episode. It was in my inventory, though, so, like, how would I have accidentally thrown out something? It wasn't, like, on my bar. I always, like, I'm very OCD. I keep all of my stuff. Was it there when I went to grab the other pack? Did I just toss it out like a minute ago back at the lake? I didn't see it floating there. Hold on. So it was in here. What would I have been messing with? I went into the ender chest to get the name tags. Oh no. Guys, this is the worst. And you guys, unfortunately, are sitting there watching, like, you know exactly what happened to it. No, crud. We came in here, messed with the parasaurs. I must have just accidentally thrown it out back at the lake. Okay, very quickly. Come here, Casper. I mean it when I say quickly. Let's head back to the front of the park very quickly. If I can't find it, I mean, I guess it's too bad. I mean, hold on, I also did look in this chest at one point, so I wanted to see what materials I had in here versus what I needed to grab for my pack. Nope. Okay. All right. Rod. That is unfortunate. Okay, so we went to look into our tools pack for the purposes of finding an empty shell potentially. So let's. Right. We're able to see pretty well in the water, so let's just quickly scan. Really, if that's not here, it's gonna be bad. It's the green one, right? Yeah. I don't see a green backpack just floating around in here. Well, that is gonna put a bit of a damper on our plans for today. Just a bit. I mean, we can still accomplish some stuff, perhaps. Oh man, what did I do with it? Oh, I'm gonna have to go back and look at the footage. Okay, but yeah, it's fine. We'll make it through. It'll be okay. I don't remember how to make the collapsible one now. It was like I had to look it up and I made them last time before I was got off. Oh crap. Anyway, we'll worry about that more in a minute. Let's head to the back of the park and continue what we were gonna do today. We have another name tag. We've got the name tag for the new female Jurassicraft Gallimimus. And then we've got another Gallimimus to hatch. We finally, off camera, I was able to get finally a successful cultivation for the Fossils and Archaeology Gallimimus. And so I wish there was a... Honestly, it might be like super easy mode or something stupid, but I wish there was a config option for the cultivators to be like, cultivation failed, or, you know... Like, where you could set, you know, false for cultivation being able to fail or something. Like, so it just, you could set status, so it just wouldn't do that. Because I think it's stupid. I get why they do it. Because they've got the Phalosaurus thing and they think it's a cool thing or whatever. But, like, I don't know. I prefer how Dresscraft does it where that doesn't happen. Okay. At least it wasn't the creatures pack. The tools pack just had, like, items in it, like blocks. The creatures pack has like my actual dinosaurs. So that would have been right. But yeah, it was materials pack. All right. So, in fact, we need to bring it back. So let's go ahead and pop this open. Got a Gallimimus egg in here, and then we've got our two. Yeah, Arsenia Therium in here, which we'll install back in their enclosure. So creature pack back here. Something it was just invisible. Okay, so this little lady is gonna be forever known as Standy. And she's kind of a sandy little color, so whoa, Gambit, hey buddy, what's wrong with your neck, mate? You hungry, mate? Here. Yeah, eat up. You too. Why don't you kids just have a snack? Okay. Let's go ahead. Perfect. We've got this still set. Oh, look how tiny and cute they are. Oh, man. Fun. Okay. And we've got our gear on. 8%. 9%. Okay. I do think we probably have enough time here to quickly. We're going to make a jog over here and get the Arsenia Theriums out. But I suspect we'll probably still have time do that and get back. It's not, we don't need a lot of popping circumstance over here. They've already been. I don't know what you're mad about, but I don't think it was me. Oh, I wonder if when Fabe was here, Rods killed him. I don't know why, but Rods decided he wanted to kill Fabe. I'm wondering if he took a swing at that guy as well. Okay, so let's. All right, so Kratos and Arsenic, which means Vulcan is the one who died, so we'll have to remember that. Oh, we were gonna, in fact, we might be able to do that today. Well, the episode's getting a little long already. Next episode we will plan, since we're doing these more than weekly these days, I've removed some of my less popular series off the channel, which leaves me free time to do, just focus more in on my more popular series, which I'm actually really enjoying. And so, yeah, that'll be fine. We don't need to like cram everything into one episode. Oh my gosh, only 43%. Well then. All right, let's check on Diana while we're here. Diana is 14. She's an omnivore, hunger. Ooh, she's pretty low on health. I can't get her health. I need to make some health potion. I must have turned off hunger. I don't remember doing that, but maybe when I was messing with the config options at some point, I decided that was something I needed to do. So I told you guys that we're going to be doing some naming stuff, and I guess we can probably, I guess I'll talk to you about it, and I'll give you guys I'll reveal the actual name to you guys maybe next time. But I spent the other night, and I was able to come up with some really great, and Shane's going to love this, but I was able to come up with some really great, whoa, Gambit, hey, whoa, watch it, buddy. I don't know what's going on with his neck right now, but I think we need to get a doctor in here and figure out what's going on with him. This little, hopefully, lad needs to warm up and not be pushed away from his lighting. But I came up with some really good punny names. Oh yeah, here we go. Came up with some really great punny names for restaurants and food stands around the park. They're gonna be amazing. And so we'll probably talk about that more next time. I didn't end up coming up with a punny name for. Oh my gosh! I think this might actually be a male. Hold on. No, it's another female. Okay. I just saw more green in the coat, but I guess Diana started off a little greener too. So another female, which isn't a big deal. Like I said, we're going to have several of each Gallimimus subspecies in here. So we've got the dress craft and the fossils. We've got the fossils and archaeology ones. And we're going to have more than four, our general four in here. So I think that'll be fine. I don't know what this stupid Enderman is doing, but he really needs to slow his roll. I don't know if Lucille roaring is like throwing his aggro or something. I'm not sure what he's doing. I don't know who he's mad at. I don't know what's going on. It's not raining. I don't know what he's doing. Okay, well, guys, I think that's gonna actually be it for today. I need to figure out what happened to my materials pack. We were gonna do a little bit of work on the what we've been working title Tiki Bar. We were going to do a little bit of work on that today. I don't know what happened to it. I'll have to go back and watch the episode. I'm sure at some point, like, I dropped it or something. I don't know what might have happened to it. It's really frustrating. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Next time, what I think we'll definitely do is, now that we know which Arsenio-Therium died, it was Vulcan, I'll need to go back and figure out what episode we had, birthed Vulcan, and figure out which one she died in, and things like that. And we also have a Parasaur, I think, to add as well. So we'll probably do that stuff at the start of next episode, and then we'll probably come over here and finish working on the Tiki Bar, and I'll reveal some of the punny names I've come up with for the food establishments here in the park. I think it's gonna be, I'm really looking forward to it. And unfortunately I couldn't come up with anything good and punny for this particular place, but I have several for other kinds of food establishments. So I think it'll end up working out all right. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I've been Tormer the Great, and you guys have been great. We need another name. Yeah, we've got a new female Gallimimus in there, so you guys can feel free to give me names for her as well. And if you want to if you like suggested a name for the other female Gallimimus and you'd like for me to consider that as well, just go ahead and say it again. Because again, the fact that I didn't choose yours is no bearing on the quality of your name. It's just I had to pick one, and so that's what I did. I picked one. And so yeah, if you want that under consideration again, please feel free to do so. But I will stress that if I've used your name, so I'm specifically talking to the Standy crowd, I've used Standy. I'm not naming any more dinosaurs Standy. Do not spam Standy in the comments anymore. I did it. You've been appeased. Let's move on. So, yeah, I mean, and just try to think, you know, I have a fairly specific, not specific, but like, if it's not a noun, then I'm not going to name it, you know, that. So, like, you know, but Gustav, or no, Avalardo suggested Bonjour. Well, Bonjour is not a name. It's not a name, it's not a noun, it's not a thing. Like, I'm not gonna name something that. So just kind of keep that in mind as you guys are suggesting names. Like, I don't want you guys to feel bad that I'm not picking your names, but, you know, I have a kind of a specific way I'm looking to name these dinosaurs. They've all got very varied names, but if it's not a name or, like, a thing or something, probably not going to end up being on one of my dinos. So, just a thought. Why do I still... I just recently fixed this road with lighting. Why do I still have all these torches here? I finished this walkway. When the light is in, I shouldn't need torches anymore. Keep that one there. The rest of this should be cleared out by now. There we go. I don't know how I haven't noticed that. It's been a little while. I think just before Fabe came, I fixed up this road. So it's been a bit since I've come down this road several times since, and I'm just now noticing that there's unnecessary torches about. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I've been Tormer the Great, and you guys have been great. Make sure to leave those likes, comments, subscriptions for me, guys, and I'll see y'all back here next time as we lay a couple of dinos to rest and do a little bit of work on finalizing the Tiki Bar. Hopefully, I can find my materials pack somewhere that I might have stuffed it without thinking about it. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a good one.